The best way to cap off a Monday is watching postseason football
on KCCI.
Darn right, it is football Monday night. The second round of the high school playoffs taking place tonight all around the state of Iowa. Good evening and welcome to a special playoff edition of Football Friday Night here on Iowa Sports Leader. I'm Andy Garman. Tons of games to get to. Let's jump right into it with a 4A second round showdown. Southeast Polk playing host to Marshalltown, a battle of two top flight quarterbacks. Blake Gimble for Marshalltown, Kyle Starcevich for the Rams. Early on, it was Starcevich handing off to Jordan Beam. Touchdown 7-0. EP. Later in the first quarter, Cam Lawler, the fullback, takes it in from a yard out, busts his way in, and it's 14-0 at the end of the first quarter. But back come the Bobcats. It's Gimble. Look at this play design. Rolls out, spins around, heaves it up. Colton Fuller, touchdown. 14-7 at that point. SEP comes right back. It's Starcevich. Play action fake. Wide open on the post route is Nate Cameron, and he turns on the Jets, breaking the tackle. This one all Rams down the stretch. Southeast Polk rolls 52-17. They would face the winner of either Dowling or Waukee second half action at Williams Stadium. Pat Gray for the Warriors. His pass is up, and it is picked off by Mason Magruder. Nice return going the other way. That would set up his offense. Nick Wilson playing quarterback, buying all kinds of time, and then over the middle, Nathan Merle is there, and Nathan is gone. 79-yard touchdown pass. Maroons beat the Warriors 38-0, the final. Ankeny hosting Sioux City East, the top-ranked Hawks trying to stay undefeated in the second round. Ankeny's first drive, 4th-and-9, they go for it. Joel Lanning, great throw and catch to Marshall Clark. That's a first down, kept the drive alive, and that would lead to a Lanning dive by the quarterback into the end zone, following his blockers, 7-0 Hawks. Sioux City East would go 3-and-out. Ankeny's very next offensive play, it's Lanning. Looking deep over the middle. What a throw and catch to Ian Begg. He's gone 14-0. Ankeny rolls 45-10. Who would they face next? Scott Reister has that.
Defending state champion Valley doing what they wanted to against Johnson tonight. Up 21-10 in the third quarter, sophomore running back Drew Gray muscles it in from short, puts the Tigers up 28-10. Later in the third quarter, Tanner Stein from the 20-yard line. Tanner Hankel goes up and gets it, puts him up 35-10. The Tigers roll, ending Johnson's season. 42-17, the final. But the bad news for Valley, they lost running back Tyus Mason to a sprained knee. He did not play in the second half. It's unclear whether or not he'll be available this Friday night when the Tigers host Ankeny.
Clearly we're a better offensive team when he's in there, but Drew Gray came in and did a nice job tonight. So we're going to show up Friday night and play whether he can play or not.
Scott Reister, KCCI, Iowa Sports Leader.
All right, thank you, Scott. Let's take a look at 3A action. It is Clear Lake in the dome against the 10-0 Grinnell Tigers. First drive of the game, Eli Dunn goes way deep to Zach McGriff. Down at the goal line. That would set up this touchdown plunge. Grinnell up, Grinnell wins 33-10, the final. Carroll trying to be the upset Cinderella team of the year. They're 4-6 in the playoffs, playing at Council Bluffs Lewis Central. For the Tigers, Nate Johnston from a yard out plunges it in, and Carroll's up 19-7 in the third quarter, feeling the upset, but Lewis Central would fight back on the punt. Mike Plunkett falls on the loose ball. Lewis Central would take over. The Titans come back to win 22-19, the final. West Marshall undefeated in 2A, taking on Nevada. Nevada's Colin Black hands it off to Chase Dobson. It's fumbled, picked up by Dale Hilleman, and he's going the other way for the score. 7-0, West Marshall on the board with the defense. Then on the kickoff, Nevada's Trey Pelzer trying to bring it back, but the ball is knocked loose from him. After the nice run back, West Marshall would fall on it, and that would begin the Duncan Furt show. Couple of rushing touchdowns in the first half. West Marshall wins 27-7, the final. They knock off the Cubs. Bondurant Fluor, 9-1 on the air, taking on Mid Prairie. Blue Jays up 10-0 second quarter. Colton Hadler dives in from a few yards out. It is 17-0 Blue Jays at that point. Bondurant runs away and wins 33-0 the final. Number one, Woodward Granger in Class 2A, taking on Griswold. Hawks have blown everybody out this year. Taylor Ashman to Tanner Canova. Great grab dragging his defender, breaking the tackle. He's gone 8-0 after the conversion. Woodward Granger wins 24-13 the final. They move on to the third round. And in Class 1A, Council Bluffs St. Albert playing host to Van Meter. Our final stop tonight, special teams always important. That is a tip block punt by Tucker Collett. He scoops it up. Ball's live, and Tucker takes advantage. Nobody tackles him. He's on his way to the house. Council Bluffs St. Albert ends the year for the Bulldogs. 42-7 the final. That's it for Football Monday Night. Back with more after this.